This is our 16th annual People, Pets, and Vets event. We co-host the event with the Michigan Veterinary Medical Association. And the whole goal is to provide a free, fun day where we can educate the general public on all different types of information regarding animals. The main focus is educating the public, but while they're here and they get to see what's involved in a lot of different careers, not just the veterinary technician program or the vet assistant program, like the programs that we run here at Macomb, but they can also see what wildlife rehabilitators do, what their jobs are. We have a large animal vet who's talking about how to shoe horses, so they can learn a lot about different possible animal-related careers. We're going to be doing a lot of demonstrations this year. We have the police department with their bomb-sniffing dogs and drug-sniffing dogs. 4-H, one of their main goals is to, again, educate the public what they do, how they take care of their animals, and what's involved with being part of 4-H.
This is a Nubian. He is one of the two largest dairy breeds. He runs about 220 pounds. He is a Wether, which is a castrated male. And then this one is a pygmy. She is actually a meat goat, and she is one of the two smallest breeds of goats. And she's about 40 pounds. They were originally brought to the United States on ships, and they were used to as a meat source for people on the ships. They then became popular with zoos and circuses as they used them as meat sources for the big cats. They had limited amounts of grazing area and, you know, feed, and due to the traveling nature of the circuses. And then zoos were limited in their space, so they utilized those as meat source, fresh meat for the big cats.
This is a silky chicken. Silky chickens don't have the barbule part to their feather, so that makes them feel like they have fuzz instead of feathers. They also have an extra toe. Normal chickens only have 4 toes. These actually have 5. They have 3 in the front and 2 in the back. And this is actually a full-grown chicken. They're not babies at all.
We started training when she was a puppy. I got her about 6 months old. She did basic classes, and then when she was about a year and a half old, I put her in therapy classes to learn how to go out in the community and work with people in hospitals, nursing homes, rehab centers. She loves children, so she goes to like Grace Centers of Hope. She does a lot of activities with kids, orphanages, things like that.
Gilbert, he's one of our 9 ferrets. It's salmon oil. It's something that most domestic ferrets enjoy. They're primarily carnivores, so fish, chicken, things like that they quite enjoy. The salmon oil, I actually train them with the salmon oil, so they'll let us do nail trims, ear cleanings. As long as they're being fed this, they can do about anything to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, some of the highlights of our People, Pets, and Vets, or some of the things that have been popular over the years, is our Healthy Pet Surgical Suite. We do live spays and neuters on animals from the shelter. We have veterinarians from the Michigan Humane Society come in and perform these spays and neuters. The public can watch through the window, and then they can also watch it on TV. We have it photographed so that they can, or videographed so that they can watch it. And then we also talk about the importance of spaying and neutering, what the benefits are, and answer any questions that the public has. Another highlight is our teddy bear clinic, where children can bring their teddy bears that maybe need some type of help, whether they have a broken bone or whether they have a tear that needs to be sutured up. And then the students from the Vet Tech program will bandage any broken bones, and then they will also suture up any areas that the teddy bears need suturing.